Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So we are reading from Bhagavad Gita as it is. Chapter 13, verse number 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this verse is described 20 items of knowledge. So I'll read them again. 20 items, please be attentive. Humility, pridelessness, non-violence, tolerance, simplicity, approaching a bona fide spiritual master, cleanliness, steadiness, self-control, renunciation of the objects of sense gratification, absence of false ego, the perception of the evil of birth, death, old age and disease, detachment, freedom from entanglement with children, wife, home and the rest, even-mindedness amid pleasant and unpleasant events, constant and unalloyed devotion to me, aspiring to live in a solitary place, detachment from the general mass of people, accepting the importance of self-realization and philosophical search for the absolute truth. All this I declare to be knowledge, and besides this, whatever there may be, is ignorance. Hare Krishna. Is right time?
8:45.
So in the previous verse, Krishna has described 24 elements which constitute the body, kshetragriha, the field of activity. The soul proper has nothing to do with these 24 elements. The soul is sat, chit, anand, has nothing to do with matter. But because of some miscalculation, the soul comes to this material world and gets trapped, gets entangled in this body made of 24 elements. And for the purpose of happiness, for the purpose of enjoying senses, the soul uses the body to perform karma, to perform activities which further entangle the soul. So it is a very complicated situation. So a process of knowledge is required to come out of this complication, to get liberated from this entrapment of 24 elements, to come out of this body, to cut these attachments. Like a diseased person requires a process of cure. It may be diet, plus medicines, plus certain lifestyle changes. A whole process is required to come out of disease. In the same way, the process of knowledge helps us to come out of this entanglement. So that process of knowledge Krishna has described in these few verses. The total items are 20 items. These 20 items help us to come out of the entanglement of cycle of birth and death. These 20 items help us to get liberated, to come out of this fruitive activity, to come out of this sense gratification, to come out of the cycle of karma and karma phala. So these 20 items should not be considered as part of the 24 elements or their interactions. Even though they appear to be bodily activity, but they are helping us to liberate, to come out of it. For example, if somebody is walking barefoot in the forest, he will get struck with a thorn. Now to remove this thorn, he will use another thorn. Both are thorns But one we will call good thorn, one we will call bad thorn. Because one which is giving you pain is bad thorn. One which is helping you to come out of pain is a good thorn. But after using the good thorn to remove the bad thorn, both the thorns we throw. We don't throw the bad thorn and to give the good thorn in the pocket, oh, this was nice, it helped me. Both we throw. So even though some material activities entangle us and other activities help us to come out of entanglement, but finally both have to be given up. The body has to be given up. So those activities which help us to come out of entanglement, even though they appear to be bodily activities, but they should be accepted because they help us. For example, our tongue. If we use our tongue to talk about sense gratification, then we get entangled. But if you use the same tongue to chant the holy name of Krishna, then we come out of ignorance. We get purified. We come out of cycle of birth and death. So whether tongue is bad or tongue is good, that's not the point. It can be helpful to come out of ignorance, to come out of entanglement. So we perform that activity. So when we vibrate Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, it is not part of Kshetrajna. Even though the tongue is involved, and tongue is one of the element out of five Karmendriya, mouth is one of them. Tongue is one of the element, but the vibration of holy name helps us to come out, to get liberated, to get free, to become independent of the entanglement, so it's considered part of the process of knowledge. It is not considered fruitive activity. It's not considered part of 24 elements or their interactions. So those who are ignorant of spiritual knowledge, they think these sadhus, these brahmacharis, they are not vairagi. They are traveling in car, they are using laptop, they are using mobile, and this car, laptop, mobile is part of 24 elements. Basically 5 elements: earth, water, fire, air, ether. And we already just discussed 5 elements. Object made of these 5 elements is part of field of activity. And the soul is trapped in the field of activity. So the soul has to come out of the field of activity. So soul has to give up all the 5 elements, all the 24 elements. So mobile, laptop is made of these elements. So it's entangled. That's true. But when the same object is used for service of Krishna, one has service attitude, one does not have enjoying propensity, then that is not to be renounced. In fact, that will help one to come out of entanglement. Like one thorn will help to come to remove the another thorn which is giving pain. So utility of Kshetrajna, utility of Kshetra, utility of the field of activity, as per the process of knowledge given in these verses, will help us to come out of it. So all this, like humility, tolerance, cleanliness, simplicity, compassion, these are all good qualities. And out of all these 20 items, the most important is unalloyed devotional service to Krishna. Ananya, unalloyed, pure, transcendental, without any personal ambition, without any personal motive, without any selfish desire. When we serve Krishna, that is the goal of life, that is the goal of knowledge, that is most important item of knowledge, that is most important item in this all verses. That one should become pure devotee of Krishna. We all are constitutionally servants of Krishna. We have love for Krishna, but now we have forgotten that relationship. So we have to revive this relationship. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in his Shikshashtakam, he prays, Na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim, kavitam, va, jagadisha, kamay, Mama janmani janmaneshware bhavatat bhakti ayetuki toi. कि आई डोंट वॉन्ट धनम वेल्थ, आई डोंट वॉन्ट जन्म गुड बर्थ, आई डोंट वॉन्ट सुंदरी एसोसिएशन विद ब्यूटिफुल वुमन, आई डोंट वॉन्ट फॉलोवर्स, आई डोंट वॉन्ट मटेरियल ऑपुलेंस, आई डोंट इवन वॉन्ट लिबरेशन मम जन्मनी जन्मनीश्वरे, आई डोंट इवन वॉन्ट लिबरेशन, आई वॉन्ट ओनली भक्ति प्योर डिवोशनल सर्विस एंड टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ कृष्णा बर्थ आफ्टर बर्थ. So that is the desire of a pure devotee, that he wants to serve Krishna. He doesn't even want liberation. So that is our natural position. That is our constitutional position. That is our swarupa. Nitya Das. We are Nitya Das, eternal servant of Krishna. So we have to come to that platform where we perform devotional service to Krishna purely. On the transcendental platform, Vasudev state is called, Vasuddha Sattva, Vasudev state, beyond mode of goodness, beyond passion, beyond ignorance, and beyond goodness, for pure goodness, where the activity is only for pleasure of Krishna. So this is the final aim of life, this is the final goal of life, this is the most important item in this verse, this is the purpose of all knowledge. If a person is very educated but doesn't come to the platform of serving Krishna, then he is not called educated. He is called uneducated dog. He is called an animal. Because the human form of life begins after animal life ends. But if somebody does not serve Krishna, then he is still doing animalistic activities. He is not called educated person. He is called fool. What is the use of that knowledge, that education, if it doesn't help you to serve Krishna? So, unalloyed devotional service to Krishna is the most important item of knowledge. And this cannot be achieved without another item, which is to approach a bona fide spiritual master. One cannot become a devotee of Krishna just by reading books. One cannot become a devotee of Krishna just by independent practice. One should be taking shelter under the guidance of a bona fide spiritual master coming in parampara, and then only one can practice devotional service. One cannot do whimsical devotional service. Imagine somebody reads in Nectar of Devotion, one should offer incense sticks to Krishna, Agarbatti, as devotional service. So he goes to his home, night 2 o'clock, wakes up, opens the altar and burns 500 incense sticks and keeps it in front of the altar. Is that devotional service? Yes or no? Why?
Because Krishna is sleeping at that time.
Krishna is sleeping at that time. Right, and? And any other mistake in this? One is improper time.
Not bona fide.
Huh?
Not bona fide process.
Not bona fide. Yeah, why? What is the another mistake he is doing in this?
Yes, I heard from his Krishna.
Right. So 500 agarbattis, if you put it in the altar, it will be so much smoke. Would he be comfortable, Krishna? He's a person. Why to make so much smoke? So this is whimsical. He read, but he didn't understand the process. So he has to have guidance. That how to offer, when to offer, how much to offer. There's a whole process. Just by reading Puranas, one cannot practice devotional service. Because our mind is so polluted and contaminated. So by the guidance of a spiritual master who can engage a person according to his nature, as per time, place and circumstances, one can go ahead in bhakti. This spiritual master is representative of Krishna, a pure, transparent media in between the disciple and Krishna. And hence, because he is transparent, the relationship works. what the candidate, what a disciple offers to the spiritual master, being transparent, it goes to Krishna. And what comes from Krishna, being transparent, comes to the disciple, the blessings, the instructions. So when the guru is happy, guru is pleased, Krishna is pleased, and the disciple gets blessings, and he advances in spiritual life by pleasing the bona fide spiritual master, which pleases Krishna. He or she advances in spiritual life. So that step of approaching a bona fide spiritual master is compulsory in order to come to the platform of unalloyed devotional service to Krishna. Taking shelter of a spiritual master means pariprasnena sevaya, means hearing from the spiritual master, asking questions to the spiritual master, and offering service to the spiritual master. These are two most important elements in the relationship between spiritual master and disciple. The disciple should hear from the spiritual master, disciple should put questions to the spiritual master, and disciple should offer service to the spiritual master. Disciple means discipline. He should obey the spiritual master. So when he obeys a spiritual master who is a sadhu, a devotee of Krishna, obviously he will engage him in service of Krishna. And when he engages in service of Krishna, he grows in Krishna consciousness. By obeying the spiritual master, he pleases the spiritual master. And when spiritual master is pleased, Krishna is pleased. When devotees chant the 16 rounds, even if they don't happen to chant very great quality, but because they are chanting on the obedience of the spiritual master who has told to chant 16 rounds, Krishna is pleased that this candidate is obeying the pure devotee of Krishna. So worshipping and serving the spiritual master means obeying. So when one serves the bona fide spiritual master, one pleases Krishna, and in that way one becomes a pure devotee of Krishna. So all of you present here, when you are chanting every day 16 rounds of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, following four regulative principles from quite some time, should consider taking initiation. Consider taking initiation by hearing from authorized initiating spiritual masters in ISKCON. And whoever you hear and get inspired, you can develop a relationship of taking shelter and then taking diksha. And in that way, that step is covered where we surrender formally to the spiritual master and get connected to the parampara. And under the guidance of Diksha Guru, who gives initiation, and Shiksha Guru, who gives instructions, we practice devotional service. Diksha Guru, Shiksha Guru, they are two different persons, but they are not different. They are considered same as representative of Krishna. A disciple should not make difference between three: Diksha Guru, Shiksha Guru, and Krishna. All three are same for the disciple. And when he offers his worship, his service to them, then he advances in spiritual life. So a bona fide spiritual master, whether Diksha Guru or Shiksha Guru, can deliver us from this cycle of birth and death, from this entanglement, by giving instructions. And we have to follow those instructions. Not just sitting and watching him, we will get delivered. We have to follow those instructions. We have to do our part. Like if somebody is hungry and he goes to mother, will his hunger go away? Yes, mother will give food, his hunger will go away, but he has to pick up and put it in his mouth. Even if the baby is small, mother puts it in the mouth, but he has to swallow it. Something he has to do. Right? So something we have to do. That's kriya. That's labor work. That's hard work. We have to use our body, our mind, our words for the service of the spiritual master and Krishna. So when we perform our activity, our duty, devotional service, that's called sadhana. Sadhana and sadhya. Sadhya means the goal. Sadhana means the process to reach the goal. So sadhana is what we do daily, routine devotional service, practice. Why are we doing sadhana? Sadhana? To achieve something called sadhya. Sadhya is the goal, Krishna prema. So under the bona fide guidance of bona fide spiritual master, we perform sadhana. Sadhana bhakti means activities of devotional service done under obedience. Raganuga bhakti means done under affection. I have affection for the Lord, hence I get up for Mangala. I have affection for the Lord, hence I chant 16 rounds or more. I have affection for the Lord, hence I read Bhagavatam. My Guru Maharaj has told me to chant 16 rounds, so I obey and chant. These two are different. So affection for the Lord and hence doing it is called spontaneous devotional service, Raganuga. Obedience to Guru Maharaj and hence doing it, that's sadhana. Both are to be done. Unless we do sadhana, we can't reach Raganuga. So spiritual life is very essential to take shelter of a bona fide spiritual master. But the goal is not spiritual master, the goal is Krishna. So the goal of life is to obtain unalloyed pure devotional service for Krishna. Alloy means mixture of one, two or more items, metals. Unalloyed is no mixture. Unmixed, pure, Shuddha Bhakti, Uttam Bhakti. So the goal is to reach that platform. And that happens by performing our sadhana under the guidance of a bona fide spiritual master. If somebody has that process, somebody is following that process of pure devotional service, then all the good qualities automatically come in that person. Generally, demigods are considered to having all the good qualities. That's why they are in heavenly planets. Humility, tolerance, simplicity, cleanliness, truthfulness, compassion, self-control, austere, detachment, renunciation. So demigods have all these qualities, that's why they are qualified to stay in the heavenly planets. So if any person practices pure devotional service, automatically he gets these qualities. By serving Krishna, by coming in contact with Krishna, by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, by chanting the holy name, we become pure and all these qualities develop in us automatically. But somebody who has all these qualities but not devotee of Krishna, then that's useless. That qualities have no meaning. Those who are humble, kind, merciful, compassionate, truthful, but they are not devotee of Krishna, they are no value. The most important quality is to be a devotee of Krishna. Everything else comes after that. So we are not here to just develop some moral qualities or values. We are here to become servant of Krishna. So most important education should be to learn how to become a devotee of Krishna. And these good qualities are required. Because when we are in the Vaishnava community, when we are associating with Vaishnavas, we should be dealing with Vaishnavas carefully. Our relationship should be based on mode of goodness. That means this quality should be present of being humble, giving respect to others, being tolerant, being self-controlled, being renounced. All these are required, otherwise we will not be able to stay in Sadhu Samaj. What we call Sadhu Samaj or community of Vaishnava, Sadhus, dealing with sadhu should be very, very strict as per scriptures, as per Vaishnava etiquette. We can't deal with sadhus as we are dealing with our relatives, neighbors and friends. Then we will not get benefit. We will get benefit only if we are dealing as per Vaishnava etiquette. Then we get blessings when we offer service. Otherwise we commit offenses. Just like if you are trapped in this room, and you have a key, that key is very valuable. But if that key, instead of putting in the door, you put in some other place, is that of any value? No, you will be still trapped. If the key goes into the lock, then only you can escape from this room. But if you don't put in the lock, But if it anywhere else, any other hole in the room, on the wall, or the ceiling, or the floor, will it help? It will not help. So key is valuable, but it has to be put in some hole, which is made for it. In the same way, Vaishnava Samaj, association of devotees is very valuable. It's a key to get liberation. But that key has to be handled carefully. If that key is not handled carefully or put in some other hole in the wall, it will not help us. Sadhus will help us when we perform proper etiquette. So these qualities are required to follow proper etiquette. So one should learn to develop these qualities, one should behave according to these qualities, and one should practice nice sadhana so that these qualities are naturally present in us. Just by being artificially good, it's very nice, but cannot sustain long term because we develop frustration. So we need to practice nice sadhana so that we develop humility, we develop tolerance, etc. So this knowledge is very important, and with this knowledge one can come out. In fact, in the 18th chapter, after telling all the knowledge, all the chapters to Arjuna, Krishna says, one who gives this knowledge to others is most dear to me, and there will be no servant who is more dear to me than this. There are so many books and so many articles and magazines in this world, but they all are about kshetra. They all are making the reader more entangled in the kshetra, in the field of activity. The literature which helps us to come out of entanglement is very rare. And that is Bhagavad Gita, that is Bhagavatam, that is Vedic scriptures. So when this knowledge which helps us to come out, which helps us to come out of the entanglement, is given to others, they get very high benefit. And Krishna gets highly pleased by that. Krishna, he has this mission. Why does he come to the material world again and again? Paritranay sadhuna vinashaya dushkrita, to protect the sadhus, to keep dharma intact. So this dharma, this knowledge is kept in the books. Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita, that contains dharma. And Bhagavatam spoken by Sukadeva Goswami, that contains dharma. Sukadeva Goswami, he was asked by Shaunak Rishi, that Krishna has left this planet, where is dharma now? Dharma was under the shelter of Krishna. Now Krishna is not here. So where is dharma? And he said, dharma is now in Srimad Bhagavatam. Dharma has taken shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. The eternal religious principles has taken shelter in Srimad Bhagavatam. So this knowledge, when given to others, they come in contact with Krishna. They get eternal dharma. They get eternal religious principles. And they can come out of this kshetra. They can come out of this entanglement. So this is not ordinary knowledge. So Srila Prabhupada, when he went to Western countries, he followed his spiritual master, who told him, if you ever get money, print books. And Srila Prabhupada, he followed this instruction. He translated the books in English language and he printed them. And he told his disciples to distribute it on the streets. The books were not going on the bookshelves by displaying in some exhibition. No, they were going hand to hand on the streets of America. And that created a revolution in the society. And even in ISKCON, which we popularly call as book distribution, wherein when we give books to others, their life changes. Prabhupada says, even if he reads one page, even if he reads one line, even if he reads one word of that book, his life will change. Prabhupada said, even if he just pays for the book and takes the books and keeps in his house, his bhakti has started, step one has been done. So after that also steps have to be taken. He has to read and practice the philosophy. But step one, we are at least helping him to step one, to new people. A good beginning is very important. Well begun is half done. Right, you heard this? Well begun is half done. So when we approach people with a smiling face, with a polite speech, with a sweet speech, and we request them to take this book, we are offering them a benefit. When we do book distribution, we are not doing business. We are not doing this to earn profit. We are not doing a business transaction. We are not a salesman. We are not trying to fulfill our target by giving him a book. We are not beggars. We are preachers. We are benefiting them. This knowledge is worth millions of rupees. In fact, invaluable. What we are charging is the money for paper and printing. Not for knowledge. Knowledge is free. So we are giving them $1 million knowledge free. We are not begging them. We are not doing business. We are not doing selling. We are out of compassion helping them. That if you read this book, you will get benefit. Just like I got benefit. You will come in contact with Krishna. You come in contact with Srila Prabhupada, who is pure devotee of Krishna. You will know the eternal religious principles. You will become a good person. You will become a good human. And if everybody becomes a good human, the whole world will change. Prabhupada said, even if 1% people become devotees, this world will change. That's a big number, 1% of the total population, crores. So we have to try to do that. We are not great. Prabhupada's books are great. And Prabhupada has given us a very great opportunity that even if we are fallen souls, conditioned souls, unqualified, but still we can lift a book and give to somebody. We can talk about the book. We can tell them the words. We can tell them what does it contain. And we can request them, please take this book and read it. And you will get benefit. Your family will get benefit. And if he takes the book, after taking the book, whether he reads or not, whether he got benefit or not, we don't know. But one thing we are sure, we got benefit. When we give a book to somebody, we advance in bhakti because Krishna is pleased. Srila Prabhupada is pleased that we gave a book. We should not think, oh, we just give a book outside the station, they don't read. What is the use? No, no, it's not like that. Some books, they explode like a bomb after 10 years, after 20 years, after 2 years, after 5 years. There are many stories in which people have bought books and kept it, not read it. And after many years, they picked it up and they become a devotee. And when we go out for book distribution, we get purified. We advance in bhakti. So everybody is getting benefit. So now we again have an opportunity. Marathon is coming. This year marathon is starting November 15 to December 15. Generally it's from 1st December to 31st December. This year we are having it early because of two reasons. One, Gita Jayanti is coming on 30th November. So Gita Jayanti is coming right in November. And second, ISKCON Jew, we are celebrating 40th anniversary of Sri Sri Radharas Bihari Mandir. Sri Sri Radharas Bihari Mandir was opened for public on 14th January 1978. So 14th January 2018 will be 40 years. So many Srila Prabhupada disciples who were part of the project initially, they would all come and would have nice Rath Yatra, Katha, Abhishek. We'll announce the program and send it on WhatsApp. So in Bombay, we are having marathon early. So we will start. We request all of you that you from now itself you plan how will you give out books. Your friends, your relatives, your contacts, your office colleagues, your neighbors. We can go in the market and distribute books, put a stall, stations. We can even go outside traffic light. In fact, some of you should try traffic lights. The traffic light is becoming very successful in Delhi also, in Bombay also. Devotees go at traffic light and when it is red light, you go to a car and knock, and if he rolls down the window, you give him a book, he gives money, very quick transaction, and they happily take. You go with nice tilak, dhoti kurta, smiling face, and tell them this is preaching work,
take this book and give a donation, very happily they do it. They take two books, three books. So we should try this. The signal I see is very busy. And cars come, they wait for a certain period of time and then they go forward. So we have an opportunity, the main signal.
So anyway, so you can approach your people around you, and everybody should take a target that this month for Prabhupada I'll do 30 books, I'll do 60 books, I'll do 100 books, I'll do 500 books. Everybody should try to take a target. There's no bar. Anybody can distribute books. Child can distribute, Mataji can distribute, Prabhupadis can distribute, old people can distribute, educated, uneducated, no bar. You just have to go out to people, and Paramatma is sitting in our heart, and the same Paramatma is sitting in the heart of the person whom we are approaching. So if we are sincere, Paramatma in his heart will inspire him to take a book. And when a book goes, we feel so jubilant. We feel so advanced, so becoming further advanced in Krishna consciousness. So this is a huge event for ISKCON. And ISKCON Jew also does almost 2 lakh Mahabhi books every year. So you all should already doing it. We should do more and more. Our Prabhupada will be very pleased when we do more and more. So we should plan it out nicely. All of you should meet together if you are not met. And plan it out where to keep the books. Who will take care of the stock? Who will take care of the accounts? Who will license to the temple? Who will take care of the stalls? And distribute more and more books. Whoever your colleagues are, your friends are, if they have Bhagavad Gita, give them Krishna book. If they have a Krishna book, give them Bhagavatam. And if they have Bhagavatam also, tell them to take Chaitanya Charitamrita. If they have that also, then tell them to help us to distribute. Everybody has an opportunity. If they already have all the books, that means they are devotees. So then they should do book distribution. So tell them, take 10 Bhagavad Gitas and give it to your friends. Give it to your contact, give it to your colleagues. And in that way, more and more people will join in the distribution. So we should try in that way. So by distributing books, the mission of preaching goes forward. More devotees become, and we also advance in bhakti. So we have a nice opportunity which we should do it. Okay? So we have a small exercise today. We started late, so give me some more time. So these 20 items, we will take one. How many of us are here? Can you count?